The health issues that you are facing, like hair loss, hormonal imbalance, and even low immunity, might have a root cause in your kitchen. So in this video, we are going to be detectives. We are going to go into your kitchen and figure out the why. We are halfway through 2019, and if you're still committed to your health and fitness goal, then keep on watching. So let's start with the biggest change that I made in my kitchen in 2019, and this was to completely get rid of all the non-stick cookware. So why did I do this? Now, all the non-stick cookware that we use is coated with a carcinogenic chemical, and when you cook food in it, this chemical is going to react with your food. This is especially harmful when the cookware is about a couple of years old and the non-stick starts peeling off. So when you use such cookware, these chemicals are going to leach into your food, making it toxic and extremely harmful. Now, the very fact that cancer is on the rise today and has become so common is because we are not doing something right in our kitchen, and probably the non-stick cookware that we have been using over the past decade or so is the cause for it. So fine, we can throw away all the non-stick cookware that we have, but what after that? So next, we are going to talk about two alternatives to non-stick cookware and where you can buy them. Now let's start with the rotis. Now to make the rotis, a great alternative to your non-stick tawas are cast iron tawas. Cast iron tawas, as the name suggests, is made up of iron, and it is a much safer and a healthier alternative to use to make your rotis and parathas. Now these tawas are a little bulky, and initially they might seem a little heavy and inconvenient to use, but trust me, it just takes about a week to get used to it. I took about a week, 10 days to figure out the proper use and care of it, and now it's just the same as my non-stick tawa. I literally find no difference at all. Now, if you want, you can watch some videos to figure out what are the best ways to use and care for a cast iron tawa. I will leave links for those in the description box below. But one tip that I can give you right now is when you wash your cast iron tawa, make sure that you dry it properly and then store it. Because if you're going to store it wet, it'll start getting rusted, and obviously you don't want rust in your food. So next we come to the question of where do we buy a cast iron tawa. The easiest and the most convenient way, of course, is to go to Amazon. I found a couple of products which had good review and good rating, and also they were reasonably priced. I will leave links for them in the description box below. But before you order yours from Amazon, it would also be a good idea to check with your mom and your grandmom if they have an old one lying around in the house. So after rotis and parathas, next let's go to cooking our sabjis and our curries. So to cook your sabjis and curries, again, there are two great alternatives. I'll start with the first one, and that is a brass utensil. Now this is a brass utensil that I use to make my sabji. This is light, it's very convenient to use, and it's also very easy to clean. And you can use this to cook your sabjis just like you would use a non-stick karai. The only thing that you need to take care of it is you can cook your food in it, but make sure that you don't store your food in the brass utensil, because when you store your food in the brass utensil for a very long period of time, the salt and the acid in the food is going to react with the brass, and that's not very good. So you can use the brass utensil to cook your food, but once the cooking is done, make sure that you transfer it out of it. Now the second option for cooking sabjis and rotis is my current favorite, and that is a clay pot. A clay pot is probably the healthiest way to cook your food. Not only is it chemical free, but the minerals and the mud in the clay pot enhance the nutrient value of your food, and they in fact add to the nutrient value of your food. Moreover, when you use a clay pot, the food in it has to be cooked at a low flame, and when the food is slow cooked, the nutrient value of it enhances. If you want to make one big change in your kitchen this year which will have the maximum health benefit, then try switching to a clay pot. Now, using this is not very easy, to be honest, because these are pretty fragile and you need to take certain precautions. You cannot make it too hot, and you know, you cannot suddenly transfer it from the stove to your counter which is cold, because it's going to crack. And in fact, I have broken two of these clay pots, and the one that I'm using currently is my third one. But that's okay, we all learn and it just gets better and better with time. So the good thing about the clay pots is that they're not expensive, so you can easily replace them and you know, get a new one. Now, to buy these clay pots, of course Amazon is always there. There are products on Amazon which have good reviews and they are also reasonably priced. I will leave links for them in the description box below. But if possible, I would request you to try and buy your clay pots from your local vendors who are sitting, you know, either on the roadside or on your markets, so that this way you support their business as well. So after removing all the non-stick cookware, let's come to the next big change that I made in my kitchen in 2019, and this is to use glass bowls to store food which is cooked. Now, usually we tend to put the food that is cooked in steel utensils, and though stainless steel is safe, or rather I would say it is safer, it is still not 100% safe because it is still a metal. And when you store cooked food in it for a very long period of time, there is a chance that the metal and the food are going to react with each other. To be 100% sure, it's better to store your food which is cooked and which is hot in something neutral like glass. So this is the reason I switched to glass bowls, and I have two glass bowls in my house. They are from the brand Borosil and they have been in my house for almost 3 years now. They are quite sturdy and they also come in different sizes, so you can pick the size that suits you best. Finding these glass bowls is very easy. Again, you can either pick them up online, or I am sure that any home store near your house will have these glass bowls. Two of the brands that I have used personally and which I can recommend to you for buying glass bowls, either get Borosil or get the brand called Trio, that's T-R-E-O. So these are the two brands that I have used in the last 3 to 4 years, and I would recommend them to you. Now let's come to the third big change that I made in my kitchen in 2019, and that is to completely get rid of plastic for storing water. So how many of you have these colorful Tupperware bottles still lying around in your home and office and you use them to store water? Now, for the longest time I convinced myself that Tupperware bottles were safe because they were of good quality plastic and they were BPA free. But the fact is that end of the day it is plastic, and if you use such bottles to store water for longer periods of time, like more than one day, and if they are in direct sunlight, then the water is going to react with the plastic, and that is not going to be very good for your health. This is especially harmful for us ladies because our hormones tend to get really affected by the plastic and the BPA that comes into water. So what are the alternatives? Now, there are two alternatives that I use now. One are these steel bottles. These steel bottles are from the brand Milton, and they are pretty basic, nothing fancy about them, but they get the job done. They are sturdy and they are easy to clean, which are my two biggest criteria. The second alternative that I have for you is a little high on maintenance, but it's very good for your health, and that is to use these brass jugs or brass tumblers. Now, these brass jugs and brass tumblers have been used in Indian households from so many years, and you know, from so many decades. In fact, I remember my grandfather used to have a brass tumbler in his room and he only drank water from it. And there is a reason for it, because when you store water in brass tumbler, the water gets positively charged and that enhances the quality of it. So typically you store water overnight in a brass tumbler and then you can drink it throughout the next day. So try and get your hands on it. Again, you can buy online, but ask around your house, especially your grandparents, if they have a spare one for you. So guys, these are the three big changes that I made in 2019, that is to completely get rid of non-stick cookware, to store food in glass bottles, and to eliminate plastic bottles from my home. Now, these changes, I will be honest with you, take time and they take more effort. We are so used to using non-stick and aluminium cookware, which are light, they're easy to use. So when you switch over to these alternatives, it is going to feel like a lot of work initially, and it'll take some time. So give yourself a week or 10 days to get used to these changes. So do remember that they are lifestyle changes. These are positive changes, and once you make them, there will be no looking back. And you're going to take care of your health and health of your family by making these changes. Now remember that cleaning and maintaining the tawa, the clay pot and the brass utensil does take a little bit of time and effort, and that's a whole new topic. So if you would like me to make a video on that, then please comment below and let me know. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do share it with your family, with your mom, sister, husband, boyfriend, friends. Let's spread the word and let's get all the nonsense out of our kitchen in 2019. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon and give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. Signing off for now, I'll see you next week with a brand new video. Bye.